Now you can see in Mumbai and Mumbai everything. It's called composite panel. You protect the building with an aluminum composite panel where you are protecting the building from sunlight, water and the extreme heat what is happening right in India. So I became a part of it. I have done around 500 to 600 projects, towers of worth 65 crores. Glacial got a project in India. It was in Srirampur. The company called Panorica. Panorica is an American based company. It is the biggest bottling or distillery plant in the world. They have taken up, collaborated with 3 grams. And they already have an IT park in India. So, Srirampur is around 25 kilometers away from Sri. So they have invited me to do a project. I have been there for 2 years with the project. Then I thought I should let us work in India. Tied up with Mr. Sachin Shetty and we started a project in India. This is what Glacial is about. This is what we are about. Details will go more in questions with him. I will tell about more about me and more about my experience. Thank you.
So Agate Tech is what I have co-founded with my co-founder Shubham, and we have an intern team of 5 people. So in January 2016, where we were going through the placement process, which I'm very sure most of you all are going through as well, and I couldn't really find a company which I could sink in with. My father here nicknamed me Harpan Mala, which means Jack of all trades who wants to do everything at once. So I knew since the very start that I am not going to be sticking to a 9-to-5 role, and I'm going to be a 24/7 person, actually going into multi-functional roles. Now, how many of y'all have an Android phone out here? Can I have a raise of hands? Yes. What is the first problem y'all are facing? The first primary problem when you want to install a new app? Storage problem, lack of space, lack of permissions. Yes. This is what we are working upon. Overcoming the constraint of space in the mobile phone so that we can have instant apps. Don't you think this is an idea worth betting your life on? It is. And with that came in a lot of problems. Indian infrastructure like the internet services haven't been that supportive enough. In fact, we've had so many latencies coming in wherein the data was not loaded and etc. etc. This is where the power of cloud came in. As in my introduction was mentioned about the Google Cloud platform, that is where we got our sync with. So this is in short what I do. And in the field of entrepreneurship, like the people from Motive, I was one of the members who founded the entrepreneurship cell in my college, Vesit, or the Vivekananda Engineering College. We've been through problems, we've been through organizing a lot of events, and also coming into the big bad world of corporate, but also finding a small quaint structure for us and thriving. Thank you.
Hello everyone, thanks for inviting me here. Thank you very much. First of all, a huge round of applause to your principal. I spoke in so many colleges, and this type of energy, supporting the students from the first year itself and implementing your idea and executing it, I've never seen this. So you know, I just want to show up, friends, how many of you all are working on your idea? Anyone here? 2, 3, that's it? Such a big principal, you have just 2, 3 entrepreneurs here? Okay, there might be a few more. I was from the employee side for around 5-6 years. I've worked with different industries, media, PR, events. That's where my forte lies. One day suddenly I just thought, let me get that entrepreneur bug, as he said, that just bit me, and I thought, let's create something for the entrepreneurs. 3 years back, I just met my mentor, my investor, to whom I pitched this idea of creating the entire ecosystem for the startup entrepreneurs. It was a great journey. In these 3 years, we have been around 15 cities. We are connected to around 10 to 12,000 entrepreneurs across the nation. We have a mentors club where we have different type of mentors coming on board with us, ready to help startups in any which way is possible. We have a group of investors which are able to fund to the startups. That's all about IZ. As soon as we just talk further, I'll just brief you more about it. Thank you.
Hello everyone. It feels very weird that I'm on the other side of the desk. A year back I was on the other side, so my story basically started when I was 17. So I built a social networking website after being inspired by the social network, and I got it to have 5,000 users. But I didn't have the resources, I didn't have the business acumen of things to run it, so it obviously tanked. But when I entered this college, I got involved with SUC, and I saw it as an opportunity to develop the business skills that I never had, the college providing already so much. And with those learnings, I founded my second company, Foodban, which was a recipe search engine. And due to some problems related to finance and development, we couldn't make it. But after two failures, here I am with my third company, which is Tortilla Studio. We are into web solutions primarily. And whatever lesson I had with RIT SOC, with the college, with my previous failures, succeeded in this one, I would say. Thank you.
Now we move on to the next question. The government has come with many initiatives like Make in India and Startup India, and many policies like demonetization and GST. So how did this affect you?
Well, the demonetization, actually the economy has gone down a bit. So as far as we are concerned, some of the builders have put up their hands. So that part we have to take care of. And the GST is good. So initially there was the service tax and the VAT tax was different. So now they have come up with one tax. So the employee and the labor and the purchase sales have all, so it is combined together. So it is good for the long term.
So yes, all the questions, this was mine, because the topic of demonetization and a second event which took place, which affected all of us personally, was the election of the American president, Donald Trump. So as I mentioned about my product, which is a provisionally patented product, and when the product's in beta and testing, it requires a huge amount of funding. Where did we get that funding from? Was when we got a lot of app assignments during this period. During demonetization, where everything, the money, the hard cash was going away, an era of fintech apps, which all of you are using right now, Paytm and Alipay, Google Wallet, I believe Google's launched Pays right now. So all of these fintech apps is what we got a lot of assignments was on. Second was when this election happened, a lot of Indian startups were unsure about their future in America. So we got a lot of outsourced work, because in India, people do not work on their own, they work on the outsourced work majorly. So that's where the assignments surged up. And about the Startup India and the Make in India program. So how many of you all know that there is a Stanford campus, a full-fledged campus in India? Yes. It's begun in 2017 at Chennai, at the Mahindra City in the Infosys campus. A full-fledged campus where yours truly is pursuing her master's from. We have to go there and come back. I travel from Mumbai to Chennai on a daily basis. So here, what we get to see that because of all this happening and the doors of the Indian government opening up, a lot of these industries from outside, a lot of universities from outside are coming and investing in India. Apple has begun their campus at Yelahanka. That's the development campus, which is under the umbrella of Make in India. So yes, this is a positive change. It is up to all us Indians, all us students, all us future engineers, how to take great advantage of this thing. Thank you.
Well, I will talk from a startup perspective. Digital India is one initiative that our government has launched, which picked up very well during the demonetization stage. And one person who really made it big was Paytm. because at that time we were not having any option apart from Paytm. So there are a couple of initiatives that government has launched very well. One is Startup India, Digital India. These are few things that is there. Initially when it launched, everybody was confused how to take benefit out of that. But yeah, now there are private players who are joining hands with the government and taking that step, getting it to the masses of the startups to help the startups to get the benefit of those initiatives. So obviously these benefits are very good from a startup perspective.
I totally agree with Nazim. From my perspective, I didn't have a lot to do with demonetization and everything because majority of my clients are based in Russian markets, US, UK. So it didn't really make a difference to me as such, but the Digital India program needs, it will grow, it will have a lot of positive impacts over the years.
Okay, so we'll move on to the next question. How did you deal with skepticism and keep your motivation in the initial month till your startup became profitable? What all challenges did you face during initial phase of company's inception?
When you start something, you need to have two things in life. One is focus, one is patience. Two things are very important when you go out from this campus or when you go out from this college. Today you start up a company, tomorrow morning you don't become a billionaire. You need to learn. Learn something from what you learn from here. Learn from your teachers. These are all called patience. What they teach us, you should listen. If you listen, there is success. Another question, I just go to another part where I have an experience. You all know about Bill Gates. I had a chance to work with him. In 2002, the ruler of Dubai gave a free land to Bill Gates. The residential plot for him to make his villa. Bill Gates, you know, he's not much keen about making houses in part of the world. But being in the Middle East hub, he thought, okay, I will make a villa. But the villa should be not in a single, you have columns, when you make villas or